falling, it's destiny calling. The power I just can't deny. It's never changing. You hear me not saying, I want you for the rest of my life. Come on, together forever in heaven.
To ever let you go. I'm going to level with you. I can't hear a whole lot when I'm up here because we've got these things in our ears, and that's how we have like a beautiful gig because everything's perfect and it's gorgeous. Did somebody just shout, "I want to see your bump"? Liverpool, raise your standards, please. Come on. They say ass. Good evening. How are you doing? I hope you realise that we're going to play a few new songs tonight, as well as some of the old ones, obviously. So, Deathly Silence. Do you want me to give you a nod when to go to the toilet? That usually means if I pick a guitar up, we're doing a new song, so that's your toilet break, okay? I've warned you, Liverpool, there you go.
Mississippi River,
dipping my feet in the cool, cool water.
As a boy, I saw my daddy crying at the steering wheel, and oh, it made me feel so scared. But then there was joy from my village, swimming in a crowd of voices, and oh, I knew that I'd been I know we're in a gig once I've sung that song, because it takes the, what does it take? It takes everything to sing that song, so I know we're in a gig, Liverpool, right now. The one thing I won't be doing much of is dancing, because I'm 58 years old, I'm on a shiny surface, I am wearing cowboy heels, and there's no insurance company in the world who will insure a 58-year-old man, I should say, on a Thursday night in Liverpool on a shiny floor. You dancing? You dancing? Are you dancing? Are you dancing? Here we go.
She wants to dance with me.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please scream and shout for Dom Joseph and Andrew Brett, come home! So while we're still in the 80s, I know that's why you bloody came, I know. Next you'll be wanting me to wear a stripy t-shirt and a blazer, won't you? Unbelievable. Unbelievable, you're so predictable, do you know what I mean? Hey? Hey? While we're in the 80s, we're going to play another song from that actual record. The title of the album actually is called Hold Me In Your Arms. Let's go. Teams here that you know all the songs in the song. I mean, come on, come on, come on, Liverpool. Hold me in your
arms.
That's good, man. That's better. Let's try the middle.
Hold me in your arms.
Mm, yeah.
Hold me in your arms.
One more time.
Yeah. Hold me in your arms.
Hold me in your shit out of you. Most of you, anyway. Listen, it's your call. Some of you are my age, some of you are possibly even older. So I'm going to give you one chance to sit down for 3.5 minutes, and I won't be offended, okay? So if you want to sit down, just sit down for 3.5 minutes, and I'll love you just the same. It's your knees, it's up to you. Well, I said that in Leeds, literally 90% of the audience just sat down. This is another slow song, because I need to get my breath back. And it's about my wife. All my songs are about my wife, the ones that I write pretty much. And, well, don't clap it, love. Don't clap now. Not yet. You haven't heard what it's called yet. Because, obviously, I love my wife. My wife is amazing, and we work together. She manages me. She basically is the key to why I'm still doing this to a great degree. But she also drives me completely and utterly crazy. So, I like playing other people's songs. I sometimes like to play other people's songs more than I like to play my own songs. Which is a bit weird, I know, but I've done it since I was 15 years old in a band in Newt the Willows, about 18 miles over there somewhere. We used to go into the Lee Arms and play
That's What My Heart Yearns For Now, Love and Pride.
Remember that? We also used to go Rip It Up and Start It Again. I said Rip It Up and Start It Again. And then we started writing our own stuff. And that's where it all went wrong. So listen, we like to play other people's songs, and I've been trying for about 18 months to find something that is better than this, and I haven't found it yet. Again, it's got to be a new song. Has anybody got the new album or streamed it or listened to it or YouTubed it or freaking whatever it? Well, that's a good job, because here we go again.
You were bad, but you were good.
never did the things you should. And you were wrong, but you were right. You said we only get one life, and I said you were much too much. You gonna be crazy, much too much, too much for me.
For a little while, which is kind of sad to be honest. We've had an amazing run over this past couple of weeks. I want to say a massive thank you to the lottery winners for coming out.
Were you in for the lottery winners? You must be in for the lottery winners.
When they go on their first arena tour, I'm going to be fourth opening act on an acoustic guitar. And I'll just play Never Gonna Give You Up three times. Also want to say a massive thank you to Scouting for Girls as well. Because they've been amazing. They joined us in Ireland. We came over tonight as well. And they've just been fantastic. Absolutely amazing, all of them. So thank you very much. Would you please scream and shout? Give a proper Liverpool scream and shout for both those acts. Come on! Okay. I warble. I croon. I strain, I pinch myself, I do all kinds of things to get the notes out one way or another. These two tigresses, it's what they do, it's what they do. It's just in there. And at the end of this song, they're gonna give it to you 100%. This is Cry for Help.
my time. Convinced that she's fine, but when she leaves, I'm not so sure. It's always the same. She's playing her game, and when she goes, I feel to blame. Why won't she say she needs me? I know she's not as strong as she seems. So why don't I see her cry for him? Why don't I feel her cry for him? Why don't I hear her cry for me?
Oh, go on, turn your phones off. Turn your lights off. Come on, let's have a moment.
Yeah. I wandered around the streets of this town, trying to find sense in it all. The rain on my face, it covers the trace of all the tears I've had to waste. Why must we hide emotions? Why can't we ever break down and cry? Why don't I see her cry for him? Why don't I feel her cry for him? Why don't I hear her cry for him?
No need to feel ashamed.
Why don't
for you. This song is about God meeting the devil in a local park just on the edge of Liverpool. God walks home through the local park, meets the devil with a broken heart. He says, I've been let down by the armies of darkness. Now my whole life's a mess. And God says, I got the cure. Yeah, I'm holding on to something pure. I got the cure for you.
Some fun in his hand. Beelzebub knows, he knows he's gotta save this man. And the devil says, I got the cure. Yeah, holding on to something pure. I got the cure for you.
That is, by the way, that you actually know some of the words and that you actually know the songs that I've been doing for the last few years, because believe me, I love singing the old ones. I know I laugh and joke about it, but I love singing the old ones. They're the reason that I'm here and I know that. But it is an amazing feeling when you play a song and people go, yeah, I kind of know this. I'll tell you another amazing feeling, and that is being on tour with professionals, people who are amazing at what they do. Everything that you see, everything that you hear, even the freaking stage was not here this morning at 3 o'clock. And I'm talking AM. People get off buses while, not everybody, but most of us are asleep, and they go to work and they build a ship and they put everything up here exactly as it was a couple of nights ago in Dublin, when it's in Belfast and Manchester and so on and so on. They give it everything every single day. There's a gang of people who also feed us, keep us nourished, and do absolutely everything so that the other guys can go and work and do what they have to do. I'm talking about our crew, obviously. Crew is just a small word. It's a stupidly small word for what they actually do. Would you scream and shout, please, for the amazing work that our crew and all the crews around the world, all the local crew here tonight as well. Please give it up for all the guys and girls working that you don't see. They don't get to come under the lights. Come on, Liverpool, give it to them. Every one of them and every one of the guys and girls on this stage are literally angels to me. They are the angels on my side.
Sometimes I just don't feel like waking up. Wanna stay out in my dreams. Sometimes I feel like I am breaking up. Do you know just how that feels?
Really loud. Oh, do get on with it and play something from the 80s.
I'll bring my love to you. I'll bring my love to you. I've been stuck up, messed around, take on for a fool.
go, Jay. Let's go. Come on.
Thank you.
Like I said, I'm from New Tilly Willows, which is down either the East Lanx Road, as I used to always drive down, but the M62 as well. It's a tiny little place, really, but it's where I got started with some friends in bands and stuff. I went to Selwyn Jones High School. I know, it's all right. I'm just hoping there's someone here from Newton, that's all. And I was absolutely invisible as a 15-year-old kid. I was kind of spotty, I had ginger hair. And I don't diet, you bastards, just before anybody starts. I joined a band with two friends, Jeff Spencer, Phil Bond, and we played covers, obviously, like I said before, we played other people's songs. And we got to play at the Valentine's Disco. Oh yes. And I just turned 16. My birthday was on the 6th, and we played on the Valentine's Disco. And that year, the invisible kid with spots of red hair became a sex god. Because I got five Valentine's cards that year. Which is why I made sure that I stayed in a band. And then I realised, forget being a drummer, get to the front. Liverpool. Crazy as it may seem for me to scream this, do you want to rock?
Yeah.
There you have it. There you have it. And that 16-year-old young lad from Newton Willows kept going, but at some point found the courage to be this singer and thought, I better go and get some fancy clothes. So I went out, I bought myself a stripy t-shirt. And a blazer. And the video director said to me, you're not actually going to wear that, are you? And I said, never mind wearing it, Sunbeam. I'm about to conquer the fucking world in it. This is not the last song that we shall sing tonight. There is one more after this, but I'll warn you now, it's gonna get a bit weird after this. So if you wanna get to your cars, wanna get to the pub, wanna get to a babysitter, or whatever it is that you need to get to, we've got one more after this, but it's gonna be a bit freaking weird. So if you leave, I won't be offended. We're no strangers to love. You know the rules, and I felt commitments while I'm thinking of. You wouldn't get this from any other guy. I just wanna tell you how I'm feeling. I gotta make you understand. Never gonna pick you up. Never gonna let you down. Never gonna. I'm never gonna make you cry. Never gonna say goodbye. No, 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 no. You still got it. You're still beautiful.
Never gonna give you up. I'm never gonna let you down. Never gonna run.
It's time to thank the band, it's time to introduce the band. I need you baby, to start stamping your feet. Come on, stamp your feet, clap your hands, a little growl. Give it everything you've got for the wonderful tour, Chelsea. Same again, the very same thing, even louder, stamp your feet. Clap your hands, roll, growl, for Andrew Grant. He plays the piano, he's a reverend, he's not really a reverend. We would definitely like to come back to Liverpool if you want us. I will level with you. It's a good gig to finish a UK tour on. I'll tell you that now. We're not stupid. We look at the dates. We say, where are we going last in the UK? We're going to Liverpool. So if we come again, will you come again?
If we come again, will you come again? If we come again, will you come again? We're coming, we're coming back to Liverpool. We're coming, we're coming back to Liverpool. We're coming, we're coming back to Liverpool.
I know it's your birthday, love, but it's one of ours' birthday, so you can have this as well as your moment, but this... Eva, where are you? Come on. Oh. That's what happens when you're young and you go on tour, and you have a birthday. Eva, by the way. Massive part of our crew. 1, 2...
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear. Happy birthday to you.
I may get it in the neck later for that, but... So, I'm just going to check with somebody if we're actually going to do this. Are we going to do this? Okay, all right, we are going to do this, right. So, the first place I ever went outside of our lovely place to promote a record was Germany. And I landed in Berlin, and this was in 1987, the wall was still there. It was a crazy place anyway. And I kind of fell in love with it. I kind of thought, if this is what I'm going to be doing for the next 3 or 4 weeks, this is going to be amazing. And I just absolutely loved everything about it. And I've been going to Germany so many times over the last years, I can't tell you. And I love it every time I go. And the fans are absolutely amazing and we have a great time. And the thing is, I was in the offices of a record label at some point, and I saw a band walk in, and my chin almost hit the floor. Because this band was Rammstein. If you don't know Rammstein, leave now. We're not playing a Rammstein song, we're playing a song in honor of Rammstein and whatever that genre of music is. I told you it was gonna get weird. If you don't like the intro, just, you know where the doors are, just leave. You'll be good, you'll be all fine. And if not, I'll see you next time. Here we go.
I'm gonna go. she doesn't pencil. I like to keep my pencils nice and sharp. But this is not a drawing, this is my eye. I never use acrylic. I like to get my fingers into the oil. I promise not to spill it. This is my course now, so shall not smile.
We'll start the next tour with it. Cue the music! Good night. We are definitely leading the stage. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks very much and good night. Thank you. Thank you.